Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to click on a URL link so that it will navigate to the websites from a Power BI table. Basically, you have a customer information or supplier information or any kind of master information against which you have some URLs. And you are viewing your data against the supplier or customer or any master information. It can be sales or quantity. And you are want to navigate to the websites against each customer or supplier. How to do that? Let's try to check it out as part of this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. So before moving into today's topic, this channel contains a free content worth $1,000 and 80,000 INR worth, and this channel covers SQL Server, SSIS, SSAS, and Power BI predominantly. You also get understanding about SQL as well. Please utilize this free content and share this channel with your friends and colleagues. Let's begin our today's topic. So we are in Power BI now, and you can see it's a simple table information where you have a product and the category, and you have a quantity. And basically what I want to do is like these products contains the different websites, and I want to click on it and then navigate. So obviously you might have guessed this is the product master which contains the respective websites. First things first, let's try to have the setup. This is a text, and let's try to drag and drop and what happens. So as soon as you drop it, this is, since it's a text data type and it's showing the just a pure text even though it's a URL. But so basically you might have think we need to change the data type to web, but there is no data type called web URL, right? So what we need to do is click on this column. The thing is, you need to change the data category. Here you have different categories to define if it's a latitude, longitude. In our case, it's a web URL. Just click on this, then wait. There you go. So actually, right now you might have guessed, you thought what, however you get, you give the input that might be changed to the web URL. But on contrast, you can see like whichever has the HTTP and HTTPS extension, which will only those entries turned into your URL. Let's do that one. So let's click on this. It's a Google. So it is navigated to the respective URLs. Now you understand how simple it is. Basically, you should have the prerequisite is like you should have a URL, and that should be with HTTP or HTTPS extension. That is the prerequisite. And something without HTTP or HTTPS doesn't categorize as web URL. This is the one important note I want to share. That's why I didn't put the entries for this. This is fine. And one more thing you might have asked me is like, now this is will occupy the space, right? I have a lot of columns, four columns, simple columns here. That's why it's a website address is simple. But in your case, the URL may be very long. You cannot fit into a single table itself. What you need to do is, if you want to replace, or it's not a replace, when you click on this chain, then this will navigate to this respective URL. How to map? Basically, what I'm trying to say is, you need to attach this URL to this name field. How to do that? Let's try to check it out. So for this, this is one way of doing it. Let's keep it as such. Along with this, you can do other things as well. So let's go over here, and you navigate to the cell elements, then come over here. It's a name column. In this column, the name column, web URL. This is the alternative approach. Like you can put websites here. So I hope only these two will get the link. Now you can see the jeans, Levi's, jeans, denim got the entries. I mean the link. Now you can click on it. Control plus click, because I'm in desktop. In services, you don't need to press control. Here I'm pressing control and clicking on the link will navigate to the respective websites. I hope you understand how you can use the URL in your table visual. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.